Shot selection and all that kind of stuff, shooting and in rhythm in the offense and things like that play into where guys are on the floor.
You know what? That has something to do with it. And not an excuse, but the reality of it is that we're still learning each other. I mean, we're still a little disjointed. Even going down the stretch, sometimes we don't know where to go with the basketball, and it looks a little ugly. But we'll get through it, and while we get through it, we can get through it and still win ball games because we're that good. So, you know, it's going to take a little time. I understand it, but in the same breath, we got to make sure we each get held accountable for some of the things that we're not doing right on the floor.
It was a bad shooting night for Kobe last night. Mm-hmm. How do you get someone like Kobe out of those kinds of slumps?
He's a great player. Kobe and I actually watched the whole game together. We went back and sat down and watched the whole game together on the flight back. And, you know, during the course of the game, when you look at the end of the game, when you look 8 for 28, I think that's what he was, you're like, oh, my gosh, he's got to be a ton of bad shots. When you go back and you watch the game, you know, you see some of the shots he took. There were a lot of shots he took because I coached against him. He normally makes. And, you know, he's got to continue to figure out how to stay in rhythm or how to get in rhythm with that wrist, you know. And he might not say it, you know, but, I mean, try to hold a microphone with a torn ligament, let alone shoot it and make sure you get a follow through. That's a bear. That's a bear. And so, again, he won't say it, but I'm okay with most of his shots. And I told him that last night as we watched the game. Just like everybody else's, I thought we had some open looks that we have to knock down, and which I think we will.
Well, there were times, I think, in Saturday's game where he didn't have a shot and he was getting other teams, but then he kind of just made the defense punish by getting others involved. Would you have preferred that?
Yeah, and there were a couple of times where, you know, where I pointed out on the tape, yes, you know, here's a double team and make the pass, and he pointed it out himself. So Kobe's game, after going back and looking at the tape, for me, I'm okay with. You know, obviously, we would like to win that game. Obviously, you would like him to make four or five more shots, which he could have easily done. And then, you know, just like anybody else, we had other guys that created a double team by driving the ball or collapsing the defense, and they didn't make the right pass. So it's not just coming from Kobe. I mean, I think it's the entire team trying to figure out, okay, where are guys going to be? When are they going to be open, and how do I need to get them the ball? And I think all that will come in time.
Is that a pretty standard practice?
Say it again.
Is that pretty standard practice to watch individually with one player or another, like you did?
I don't know. That's just how I do things at times. You know, I'm going to watch tape with another guy today, and I got John Kuster watching tape with somebody else, and Messina's watching tape with somebody else, and Quinn Snyder's watching tape with somebody else. So we'll do that as often as we can, just as much as we watch, well, not as much, but we probably watch more team tape. Like, we watch tape with the team before practice. We'll watch tape with certain individuals now after practice, and we just got to do what we got to do to keep trying to coach and get better with the limited amount of on-court practice time.